Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will see how we can set up Java 18, the current Java version on Atom IDE. So at first, we will download and install Java 18. Then we will install Atom. After that, we will connect both of them. With that, we will also run a sample Java project on Atom. Let's begin with the first step, that is to download and install Java JDK 18. Let's start. At first, go to the browser. I'm using Chrome. You can use any browser. On Google, type Oracle Java. Press enter. On pressing enter, you can see the official website is visible, oracle.com. Click on it to open. On opening, on the right itself, on the official website, you can see download Java. Click on it. After clicking herein, you can see Java 18 is available now. So this is what we want for Windows. I'll go below. Here it is, Java 18. Now Linux, Mac and Windows, for all three platforms, the Java 18 version is visible. We want for Windows, I'll click here. On clicking, now you can see three files are visible to download. We will go for the installer, x64, that means for 64-bit Windows 10. Click on this file to download. On clicking, the download will start. Herein you can see 153 MB only. Let's wait for a few seconds. So herein guys, you can see we have successfully downloaded the Java 18, the JDK 18 exe file. Remember that for Java, we only need JDK now. We don't need to install JRE separately because this installation includes JRE also. So I'll just double click on it to install. Minimize this. Guys, the installation started. Now let us click on next. After clicking next, herein you can see it will create a Java directory in program files and the installation will go inside it. The installation files will go inside it. You can change the location from here, but the default is fine. Click on next. The installation started now. So guys, we have successfully installed it. Click on close. Now let us see wherein we have installed Java. Remember, it was in C drive program files. Here is Java. Inside JDK 18, I told you it will get installed here. Now herein, go to bin. Right click and copy this path. Now minimize. Go to start. Type environment variables. Herein, click on edit the system environment variables. The first one, click on open. Click on environment variables from here. Herein, under system variables, the path is visible. We will set the path now. Double click on it. Click on new and just right click and paste the same path. So we pasted the following path. Now guys, click on OK. Now herein, I'll also create another path, that is new. That is, click on new. This will be Java underscore home path. Herein, paste the same variable value, that is the path, but remove the bin here. That's it. Click on OK. We have set two paths. Click on OK and click on the last OK. That's it. So guys, we successfully installed Java JDK 18. Let's go to start. Type cmd. Click on open to open the command prompt. We will verify here that we have successfully installed Java or not. Here it is. Type Java space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. Here it is. If the following is visible, that means you have successfully installed Java 18. Now guys, we will see how we can download and install Atom IDE. Let's begin. At first, go to the web browser. I am using Chrome. You can use any browser. On Google, type Atom. Press enter. On pressing enter, you can see the official website is visible, atom.io. This is the free and open source text and source code editor. Click on it. After clicking directly, it has shown that the Windows version for 64-bit is visible. This is what we wanted for Windows 10. Click on download. The download started. It's only 190 MB. Let's wait for a few seconds. So the download completed. Double click on it to install. Minimize it. So Atom is installing. Let's wait. So guys, the desktop shortcut also got created and it opened for the first time. Now we will see how we can connect both of them. To connect Java with Atom, what we need to install a package. So for that, after opening Atom, click on install a package. Now click on open installer. Herein we will search a package script. Now you can see run code in Atom, script package is visible. Just click on install to install it. So guys, we successfully installed it as you can see here. Okay, now close this as well. Let us create a new Java project. Go to file, click on open folder. Herein let us directly create a folder on desktop. Let's say it's Amit. Click on it, select folder. Here it is, Amit folder. Right click, you can right click here and type new file. Okay, enter the path or you can directly type the name demo and press enter. Demo.java and press enter. So we created demo.java file. Minimize this and check it here, Amit. Under that we have a Java file, you can see. When you'll keep the cursor, it will show that it's a Java source file, that means a Java file. Now open it again. Now let us write our code quickly. At first type public class and the name of the class. Remember, the name of the class will be the same as the file name, that is demo. Now inside it we will add our code and understand the code. Simple code. So this is our code. At first we defined a class demo using the class keyword. After that we use the public static void main. Void main. Main is the function which is the entry point of any Java program. Public is an access specifier. Static allows the main function to be called without the need to instantiate a particular instance. Okay. Void is a return type, and main I already told you it is called when any Java application begins. String arguments is a string array that is used for entering input using command line arguments. And system.out.println allows it to print the string. System is a class, out is the output stream, and println method is used to display the string. So we have displayed two lines. Since we have used ln here instead of print, we have used println. The following will come under second line. Okay, let's see. Go to file, click on save all. So since we installed the script package, directly go to packages, go to script and click on run script to run the program. Here it is guys, you can see below. We successfully ran our program and the following is visible. Here's our first Java program, and studyapedia.com Amit things in the next line because we used println here. Okay. So guys, in this video we saw how we can run our first Java 18 program on Atom IDE. If you like the video, do subscribe to our channel Amit Things.